Microsoft 365 Defender uses automation and artificial intelligence to detect and automate threat resolution across domains. That extensive automation frees you to focus on proactively hunting across the wealth of raw data that Microsoft 365 Defender provides. Combined with your organizational expertise and knowledge, it's a powerful way to uncover the most sophisticated threats. If you're unfamiliar with hunting, I recommend that you look through our docs. After finishing this video, of course. Learn the Cousteau Query Language, or KQL, and watch our detailed training videos that'll help you become an advanced hunter quickly, so you can find and squash more bad guys. On the Advanced Hunting page, the Getting Started tab provides several basic and advanced examples, a great way to get familiar with the query language or quickly test drive our hunting capabilities. On the left side are tabs for the schema, functions, queries, and detection rules. These help you discover items more quickly by keeping them well organized. For example, the Schema tab lists the tables and columns you can use to build queries. These include correlated entities, like alerts, email, and devices, from all the data that Microsoft 365 Defender provides. You can learn more about any table in the schema by selecting View Reference on its kebab menu, or see the full documentation for even more detailed information about it. Next, the Queries tab shows items contributed by the community and stored in GitHub. Expand any category to see what's available. Below that are items shared in your organization. Great place to store queries that your SecOps team uses on a regular basis. And once you've found a good one, select Open in Query Editor from its kebab menu. Of course, you're not limited to working on just one query at a time. Multitab editing in Advanced Hunting enables you to work on many queries simultaneously. The example I opened previously hunts for credentials added to an Azure AD application, Office 365 in this case. It simply returns one row for each event where the action type is Add Service Principal or the Update Application, Certificates, and Secrets Management. Right above the results set are indicators that show how long the query took to run and a measure of the resources required. A query that uses medium or high resources is one that you might want to improve to reduce resource usage for your organization. Results like these are easier to view if you collapse the schema sidebar. Now I can more easily see that some of the results show regular, human user accounts, adding credentials to the app, when I expect to see just managed service accounts doing it. This requires a bit of investigating. Select an account object ID in the results to see the user details in the side pane. It's a sensitive account, the CIO no less, and so it likely has no business being used this way. To learn more about the event itself, select the item in the results to open the event details in the side pane. Now, I'd like to know if the user added any other credentials to the app. To focus on that user account, I'll add an additional filter to the query. Beside the account object ID, select Add Account Object ID from the kebab menu and run the query again. The new results set includes only events where the user account I'm investigating added credentials to the Office 365 app. Of course, I could take some notes and branch off from here. Better yet, I can put away the notebook and add my discovery to our incident workflow. Select Link to Incident and choose whether to create a new incident or link to an existing one. In this case, I'll create a new incident. Provide the required alert details, including the title, severity, and category. And a good description will help the next analyst in the flow to better understand why you created the incident and what needs to happen as a result. On the next page, select the type of entity impacted and which field contains the entity ID. In this case, select User, followed by Account Object ID. Once done, check your work and submit it. Now the new incident shows up in the incident queue, and the alert I created is linked to it. But you don't have to create an incident to act on the results. You don't even have to leave Advanced Hunting. Select a result in the list and select Take Actions. The list of actions available here depend on the entities in the result. In this case, Advanced Hunting presents me a list of actions appropriate for a device, like isolating it or starting an investigation. Here's another Advanced Hunting query that looks for OAuth applications accessing email both directly and via Microsoft Graph. This is unusual behavior that I don't see in our environment now, but I'd like to know if it happens in the future. So I'll create a custom detection rule to generate alerts when the query does return results. To create a custom detection rule based on it, select Create Detection Rule. Provide a name and choose the frequency at which you want Microsoft 365 Defender to run the query. Also provide an alert title, severity, category, description, and any recommended actions. Some categories also let you associate MITRE techniques with the detection. On the next page, I'll identify affected user accounts by using the account object ID. And that's it. Review the summary and select Submit to create the new detection rule. Monitoring and managing all your custom detection rules are simple. Do that on the Detection Rules page. Select a detection rule to run it immediately. Edit it, modify the query, turn it off, or delete it. To see alerts that the rule generated, select Open Detection Rule page. This is a little underwhelming right after creating the rule, but in this case, I hope it stays that way. You don't have to start hunting from scratch. Imagine that you're looking at an incident's evidence and you want to quickly see where else that evidence appears. Use advanced hunting to expand your investigation. Select the evidence, in this case, a suspicious URL, and then select Go Hunt. And bam, Microsoft 365 Defender opens a query in advanced hunting that it specifically constructed to find more instances of this suspicious URL. You can modify the query to better suit your investigation, or maybe drill down into entities to better understand the threat. Microsoft 365 Defender frees security teams to focus on more important tasks, like proactively hunting for sophisticated threats. For more information about advanced hunting, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.